Alright, I want to show you something. I took most of the starting wingers, some star players and some other relevant current names in the Premier League, and I took their overall goal contribution from their whole careers. I mean, I'm talking youth levels, everything. Just so the matches played kind of balance out for the first part of the video. And here's how that would look like. And I'll give you a moment to take that in. And here's Sterling. It's clear to see that there's a group of players who are in the 200 goal contribution club, right? So let's shake this off. And let's focus just on that elite group of players and their Premier League goal contribution, because this video, as you read from the title, is about the Premier League. The guy with a higher contribution than Sterling is Kane. And the other guy directly below Sterling is Vardy. Both are strikers, and both of them have the responsibility of taking penalties and so on. But Sterling is neither a striker or a penalty taker. And in fact, if you took both of those guys out of the equation, Sterling would be clear of any current star player in the Premier League. And I have some more to show you, but first, Sterling. Sterling is a prime example of why certain managers are so good, and this is exactly why they win so much. Sterling has never been the best player on any team, and you can argue that right now in the Premier League there's a lot of wingers who are probably more talented than him, and there's been many wingers from the past who are similar to him, and there'll be many more to come in the future who are gonna have his same style. But all those players do not have this man. You see, what Guardiola did with Sterling is crazy, because Sterling could have just easily been one of those wingers that is just a loose cannon with pace, who takes the ball, runs at defenders and just crosses in, right? Because his abilities, I mean, that's what it would suggest he would do. But in fact, Sterling's best work, it comes off the ball. That's where Sterling's strength is off the ball. And in fact, when the ball finally finds him, it's most likely that Sterling is in a position to either get a goal or an assist. That's why some managers are so good at what they do. It's not an accident. You have to know how to get the best out of players when nobody else sees it. Like I said, it could have easily been one of those situations where Sterling is fast, run down the wing and cross it. When you have a manager like that, that's exactly when players like Sterling, like Salah, like a lot of these guys, right? They exceed expectations and they become legends. Now, I want to show you something else. So, back to the graph. You've heard my argument now. When it's all said and done, Sterling will become a Premier League legend purely based on his numbers, right? Therefore, let's add the most productive Premier League legends to this chart. The goals and assist kings of the Premier League. As you can see, Sterling is already above some of them, and he's already in close proximity to others, right? And I know exactly what you're thinking. I mean, looking at this chart, he's very far away from some of the rest of the guys, right? Well, is he? A lot of people expect Kane to stay in the Premier League and chase Alan Shearer's record, right? And based on how his career has been going so far, Kane will most likely end up here. And we're saying all of that knowing that Kane is older than Sterling, but Sterling is 26, guys. It's not unrealistic to say that he will probably play around 10 more years, whether it's at Manchester City or not, doesn't matter. I actually think he will stay in the Premier League until he's 36, just based on the experience that he has from playing with Guardiola and doing what he does. So if we take his averages and we expect him to maybe not start as many games as he did in his first 10 years, well, this is where Sterling could end up. By the way, only Giggs is a winger. As always, this was your boy G Alex. Catch you in the next one. I'm out.